trying to figure out if your automations and ActiveCampaign are actually working can be super confusing and intimidating. So many people that I work with create automations and they think that they're working, but they don't actually know for sure that the automations are doing what they expect. In this video, I'm going to walk you through three different strategies to test your automations so that you can have confidence everything is working exactly how you expect it to be. First, let's talk about the components of an automation. Automations have three primary components. First is the trigger. The trigger is the part of an automation that causes it to start running. That's the starting point of any automation. A trigger can be something like a tag is added to a contact completes a form, or a contact is added to a list, and so many more options. The trigger is what makes the automation start. The next part of an automation is the body of the automation, or the steps of the automation. This is what the automation is doing. Maybe the automation is sending emails. Maybe it's adding different tags and data to custom fields. Regardless, this is where your automation is actually running individual steps within it. And then finally, the last component of an automation is the end of the automation. And this is where the automation is either ending, redirecting the contact to another automation, or performing some other type of action. But it's basically the conclusion of the automation. All of these components are very important to test and make sure they're working. Otherwise, your contacts could end up not even getting into the automation in the first place or getting stuck within your automation. Now let's talk about three ways to test your automations in ActiveCampaign. The first step to testing your automation in ActiveCampaign is to test any individual emails that are going out within the automation itself. So if your automation is sending a series of 20 emails, you need to go into each one of those emails and send yourself a test, ideally to a test account, not your primary email. Send yourself a test, make sure all of the links are working, all of the personalization tags are working, and that the campaign has a good overall look and feel, that it's click-worthy. Once you have tested all of your individual campaigns within the automation, then you're going to start testing the automation itself. When you begin to test the automation itself, this part can be tricky, especially if you have a very complex system and the automations are, you have other automations already running. What you're going to do is remove the trigger from your automation and then turn the automation to active. This will allow you to manually put your contact into the automation without having to use a live trigger. And this also allows you to test the automation without worrying about contacts coming into the automation while you're testing it. So you can just go to the top of your automation and delete the very top trigger. You don't have to have a trigger in your automation. From here, you can go to your test contact and you can manually add them to the automation. When you manually add the contact to the automation, you'll see on the automation note for that contact that it just says that it's manually added. Now you can go ahead and push that contact through the automation and ensure that it is performing as expected. Now, if you have different conditions or any type of behavior tracking within the automation itself, triggered by tags or other things, you may need to manually add that to the contact as well. But this is okay because this is still your scenario-based testing where you are testing a very similar or as close to real-life scenario as you can. You're just doing it manually. So once you have completed testing with a test contact and you've done all the steps manually, then you're going to add that trigger back in and you're going to immediately test your new process using that trigger. Now, this is really important that you do this right away because your automation is technically live at this point. But you want to ensure that you have the first contact or maybe the first 10 contacts, depending on how complex it is and what type of testing you're doing. You want to make sure that your contacts are going through your new automation first. That way, you don't have any real contacts come through it and potentially have any issues. At this point, if you have performed all of the other tests that I recommend, then your automation should be just fine, and this is your official go-live test. Once you have tested the automation on your end in the live environment, then you can be sure that your automation is working and ready for actual contacts to go through. At this point, you are ready to officially launch your automation. If you have other tools that you need to connect to your automation that help make that trigger go off, now is the time to add in and connect those tools. Now, I will stress the importance of monitoring a new automation. Always the first, few days or weeks that an automation is live, monitor the contacts that are going into that automation. Click on the contacts themselves to make sure that based on their tags or their behaviors that they're going down the different paths in the automation that you would expect them to go to. Also, continually test your automations. Depending on the complexity and the amount of contacts that you have go through any automation, I always recommend frequent and continually testing your automations. Testing frequency really depends on your specific setup, your number of contacts, but generally I recommend if you have a very high volume site, I recommend testing your automations more frequently. And I always also recommend testing automations anytime you've had a change in software, even if it's not directly with an ActiveCampaign. If maybe your opt-in tool or your form tool that is potentially linking to your automation, if that has an update, you should always test and ensure that the triggers are still properly working in ActiveCampaign. Finally, I have this really great ActiveCampaign campaign checklist as well as an automation checklist. You can grab it in the link below, and hopefully this will help you feel more confident and ready to start building more automations on your own. Good luck.